right choices, because this may be TLA's last time to make those adjustments. Their last ban was Karma previously. It looks like Echo Fox are going to stick with everything the same with that Shen ban coming through.
And again, this was Team Liquid Academy's choice of side selection in this match, and they decided to choose red side.
I think it's right, to be honest, because Sivir Karma will be left up if they continue to pick at that mid lane pool, which I don't think you do. I think now you take Sivir, but if you take Karma away, you put yourself away from picking the Soraka. But if you don't, you give up the combination. Might even pick Rek'Sai first. There's a lot of things here, but I love the Vladimir ban. I like the side selection from TLA. I think their drafting and their adaptation has been good there. It's just setting yourself up for success right off the bat, and then playing from honestly a little bit of a disadvantage.
Now it's time to see it through, as Sivir is the first pick for Echo Fox. That means Karma and Rek'Sai get through.
Yeah, that's the thing, is you want Karma Rek'Sai right now to take them. But I feel like you take the Gnar, because if they take Karma, you go, sweet, it's not Soraka.
Yeah, good point. We'll see if Echo Fox actually realized the fact that Soraka is back up once again. As the Gnar returns to solo, he took it in games one and two. Game number one, very strong performance. Game number two, not quite able to have as commanding a show because of the adaptations that we saw out of Echo Fox. That Gragas is the next follow-up.
Karma.
Yeah. They do decide to go for it. So Soraka dropped by Echo Fox for the first game in the series.
Yeah, I think that's the right move, for sure. There are some things that can compete with Karma, right? You can pick your own Soraka. But I definitely feel as though that's a little bit...
very early victor.
Ooh.
And the Soraka.
Okay.
You're making funny noises over here. What are you thinking?
Well, they know that they're playing into a Sivir Karma lane, and they still didn't pick their AD carry, so they have to think that Victor is the last top tier left in Froggen's pool to justify picking it that early and giving Froggen counterpick, because your AD carry already knows what he's getting into. So instead of hiding that pick, they pick it because they think it's priority. What's left in that mid pool? Does Froggen have the Talia? The Cassiopeia? Like...
Running down that tier list is quite frightening. He's got three champions banned against him and the fourth counterpicked away. Will he show us something new here?
I think he Cassiopeia here. It's incredibly high damage, but the Victor can mess it up with a gravity field and a Rek'Sai combo. There's a lot of things on the ground. And whoa.
Ooh, Karma mid.
It's Karma mid. All right. So it's the changeup.
Okay, so Froggen falling back on something a little bit more utility.
Okay.
Fiora goes back to KFO, and this time it's Big taking Trundle.
So the Karma is going to be up there against the Victor. Interesting, and that's why. So they wait for it. TLA get the Twitch. They get the Soraka for the safe lane. He's not against the Soraka, and guess what? He's not even against a Karma. So now the Trundle pick for the support, Trundle, Sivir versus Twitch and Soraka. Sivir reaching this Twitch during team fights, not gonna happen. The Soraka going to be able to shut down if they had picked something like a Cassiopeia, dissuades them.
Yeah.
And this pivot, a little bit crazy from Echo Fox. I'm really interested to see what happens here, because TLA have wave clear under control. They have team fight under control. They can actually have a great laning phase in multiple lanes. This is a little scary for Echo Fox, but they've pulled together compositions before.
They certainly have, and that was how Team Liquid Academy were able to win game number one, by finding superior fight after superior fight, despite difficult laning phases. Well, this time, Echo Fox have got to show us that they can pull through with something a little bit new with this composition.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be a challenge. They're going to have their work cut out for them. But again, they've had superior lanes in games, just about every game, in fact, except for, I think, even that game one, they were ahead for the first 10 minutes.
Yeah, well, they've had the Soraka every single time, and that's what I think is so great here about TLA's strategy, is you're going to take, like, the pick ban, just think about how that went. That was really well played. The last ban, Vladimir, which I thought it would be last time, but since the Soraka is such a problem, you don't have to ban the Karma. They're gonna take Karma. If you leave it up, you took the Gnar because it's high priority, and you're triple banned in the top lane. So, boom, look at what ends up happening here. I guess double ban, the Hecarim flex.
Yeah.
Not really played too much top, but
the
still.
Double adaptation.
Yeah, I feel like TLA got the better of this draft.
We'll see if they can get the better of this game, because a loss here means elimination from the promotion tournament and returning down to that challenger scene, which they have struggled so hard to climb out of.
And where they have resided for the last two splits. For a year, TLA have been down there.
Hard is going to get the first damage of the game, 50 seconds in.
Sends a message.
Exactly. Well, he's not emote spamming. So maybe you know, Echo Fox, they got the opportunity to take a deep breath, get themselves nice, calm, and collected. They do have the set advantage in this. They can't afford to lose. They don't want to. But if they find themselves in a bad situation, they do have the opportunity to take a deep breath.
You just gave me a random thought. All the players should have Mastery 5, Mastery 6, or 7 emotes just in tournament realm. In LAN.
Just because.
Get 7 for everybody.
Yep.
Every champion. Doesn't matter. Get the flares to him.
Oh, boy. Maybe not the best idea.
But
I think...
You had a real point.
Yeah. When we saw that mastery spam happening, I think it was in All-Stars, wasn't exactly the best. Because people started using it in creative ways to send messages like taunts and...
In Worlds, where everybody's trying to sync it as 5 teams. Come on. How do you not love that? Anyway... It's going to be standard lanes here.
Yeah.
They actually are hiding in the bottom bush, and they give away a bit of an advantage here. So Piglet and Stunt, they're going to try to open up on Keith.
That's double exhaust. Big trying to trade back onto Piglet. He's retreating for now.
Trundle's level 1 is crazy when he gets up in your face. He steals your AD.
Yeah, Big is at low health, but so too is Piglet. Keith, he's going to bring Stunt low.
Yeah, and Keith got level 2 off of that because he killed the Krugs. He's really ambitious from TLA. I don't know if they were expecting it to be a lane swap. I think that they thought you would swap away from this lane because it's just so brutal. Or that they'd get an advantage here. Hard level 2 ganking top. 2 minutes and 30 seconds.
Oh, this is solo in a bad spot. 200 health.
Doesn't have the leap.
Oh.
And that vital for himself as well. Doesn't get hit on that last attack. Moon hits level 3. And actually, Ward top side of map is actually correct Ward.
Yeah, looks to keep on farming, though, as Hard rushing back through the jungle.
So now, if you're Moon, you go immediately to the red. You know that he can't be there with full HP. He was level 2. Or sorry, with level 3, he can't be there. And he's going to unburrow before he actually spots him with the Tremor Sense. Killing the little ones, but now he won't hit level... Or sorry, he will hit level 3 off of this camp. Picked up some experience in the lane. Just leash it. Leash it, Moon. He wants to...
Smite gives level 3 for Hard as he's able to get it. Moon did not have his own smite, but this red buff is up, and Hard knows enough not to risk it while that Rek'Sai is nearby, so he's just going to wait and take his time.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised he's not ganking mid right now. He had about 5 seconds there that we just watched him for, where Froggen was too far forward. And yeah, he lets him get away with it, too. Okay.
Yeah, Froggen... I love that response. Oh, you're ganking my lane? Let me walk out of vision and then immediately walk back in.
So now you go back, you go through your own tunnel, and then you gank him again.
Yep.
Actually, people never expect that gank. Leaving that tunnel up is actually a little...
The double tunnel.
Well, irresponsible.
Looks like Hard might have expected it. He was just sitting around the river.
Yeah, he was there a little bit late. There was an opportunity window for it, but it doesn't matter. That blue buff is what's going to be contested next year. In that mid lane. You want to hand it off to Golden Glue. It's really low.
Ooh, they might be trying to sneak up here.
Just in case you could spot him, but that's a really short stealth now, so. So this is the plan.
Hard is about to have his smite and Moon has his own. Just deny it to Golden Glue, who's already run out of mana while KFO gets damage up top. And with the pressure that Froggen's putting on the mid lane, Golden Glue can't make it. Hard tries to trade it back. Level 4 to level 3, but down to half health. That blue buff really spicing up the situation. Hard loops around. There we go.
Back around.
Moon smites.
Still, yeah, it's actually a win there for Echo Fox because the blue does not get handed off. And you can see the state that Froggen's in right now. If he's up against a blue buff, that's just awful for him because the victor will push him out. But teleport blown from Solo. Solo got that early pressure. And I think Hard visiting top and mid, exactly where he needs to be.
all of the lanes for Echo Fox are looking really good in starting this game off. Already only 5 minutes in. 10 CS advantage for Keith, CS advantage for KFO, and he used the teleport, burned the teleport of Solo, and he's going to have that opening. Even Froggen in the mid lane already set out to open up a CS advantage.
Oh, Piglet!
He's taking a lot of damage from the pillar, not burning any summoner spells just yet. Those auto attacks doing a lot, but exhaust from Stuntopolis.
Yeah, it's still a Trundle, though. He'll regen it just by being near the minions when they die. Gets a bit of that HP back, so it's one of the reasons he can actually thrive as a support.
I'm not sure.
This is actually pretty crazy that Golden Clue walks up for those. Because what if the jungler's there?
Yeah. Like,
woo. But Froggen has teleport, and Golden Glue doesn't, so he has to ulti to clear the wave out. Even then, he may not even fully get it. Yeah, exactly. He has to back. Aerolos, so it's bad timing, so he misses three. And Froggen again.
Oh my goodness, is he going to get all of them?
110.
13 CS advantage, though he does have to burn his teleport.
And now he gets to go to the bottom side. He has such a superior back timer with the TP that now Piglet might get jumped on in the bottom side. Pillar comes through, and he got stealth.
There goes Froggen. They manage to catch Piglet, hit him with the first, but he's down to half and makes it back to the turret.
Yep. So ends up using some of that time. Froggen doesn't get to shove the wave into the turret, but it still puts Golden Glue a bit behind.
The Echo Fox, once again, opening up to an early lead in this game.
It seems like Golden Glue just can't really hang against Froggen in that mid lane, especially with the help that Hard's been providing. Hard has been not really the best jungler in terms of stats by any means, but he's still actually providing the appropriate pressure in this game to deal with TLA.
Team Liquid Academy find themselves with their backs against the wall. A loss in this game means elimination. With that kind of pressure, you've got to imagine be going through their minds. Echo Fox look cool and collected, though. Junglers will meet each other in the jungle. Hard. I think he got the better of that just a bit.
Yeah, just a bit. Piglet pretty close to level 6. I think he's going to hit it like right now. So he's very, very close. There he is. Does he ulti immediately?
Try to force Keith away.
Yeah, he might get a summoner spell for it. I don't know, but a decent amount of range.
To leave it safe.
Ye old blue buff contention when the Fiora is pushed up. This is a big no-no. I missed him.
Ooh. There he goes. Greedy recall from Keith.
This is a bad recall.
Yeah.
He just gave Soraka HP.
And wasted a lot of time.
Yeah.
Froggen is going to be gifted over his blue buff, though, as Moon heads back towards that top side of the jungle. Golden Glue is roaming down, however.
Yes, because you saw the mid laner and the jungler both on the top side of the map handing the blue buff off. So now you get to make a play on the bottom side. They don't go for extra turret damage, and no pillar either from Big. Okay.
Okay. Keith actually didn't complete his recall either. He's going to push this wave in. It is a cannon minion wave, so not going to be able to deny too many CS.
Yeah, so they're actually just preying on that. That's really cool that these teams are going back and forth like that. But we'll see how quickly he ends up pushing the wave back. He's going to miss about two on this, maybe one, just because it swaps the cannon menu. So he just misses one. So that's actually a great pack timer there for Piglet. Oh. Human error.
Yeah, nobody saw that. Problem exists between keyboard and chair.
And it actually looks like Keith is going to go for the Essence Reaver first build for Sivir. It's the more common build. I was looking at Piglet's build, and he really went for an awkward one, which is Infinity Edge into Rapid Fire Cannon, which just signals to me that as a Sivir, he may not completely trust his team. And the Rapid Fire Cannon on Sivir, you really want that Phantom Dancer. Phantom Dancer is just so good. Keeps you alive, stuff like that.
Ooh, they found Big. He's just defending his own side of the jungle. Team Liquid Academy try to collapse to convert a kill, but Echo Fox are playing it safe. Mountain Drake is on that side of the map, so a kill would be great if they could get it, but Echo Fox playing it safe, playing it patient.
And that's been their strategy, right? They have advantages in the mid lane, in the top side. This game, it's not as much in the bottom, but because of Sivir's, sorry, the Soraka's on the other foot.
I've never heard that before.
It's shoes on the other foot?
Yep. I know where that comes from.
So, Soraka's on the other foot. It's.
Yes, no, you don't have to explain.
On a saying?
Yep.
Using Soraka instead of Shu.
Tell me more while Solo attempts to defend here. He's got Meganar in hard trying to wait it out, but he clears out the minion wave.
So it's a saying that's all about no.
Catches KFO.
Great play there as well, because if he thinks he's going to get dove and he's trying to make a play on the opposite side of the map, try to do as much damage as you possibly can to prevent the dive, because now they have priority bottom side and it's much easier to get this turret. They're going to have to pull Frog into the top side. It's going to take longer. But no, he's actually going to deviate from that plan and go towards the mid still. So this is going to be a turret for KFO slowly chipping away at that top one.
Yeah, that Solo with the boomerang.
Hoodwinked there. Ended up getting the pig Krug, and that's the first turret going down. And TLA now have that 700 gold advantage for themselves. And we've seen that that's enough for them to work with in the past. Up against Cloud9 Challenger, that's all it took them to really start running away with the game. And Moon...
Froggen playing so safe, dodges around Moon, no flash used either. Froggen continuing to farm up, again, nearly 30 CS ahead, 10, 12 minutes into this game. KFO still holding on to that teleport though. Solo has got his back up as hard as on that side of the jungle, so we're starting to see some more of this scaling, some more of this transitioning forward. Team Liquid Academy are aggressively looking for some action.
I feel like they're okay with scaling too, though, because they have the Twitch. So they'll just wait for Piglet to get his Yomus and then go for a fight, because I think the Yomus power spike versus the Essence Reaver definitely in your favor with the Yomus.
Yeah.
Also, this is a long lane bottom, so if Keith and Big actually push up too far, it's quite dangerous. Also, I think a big reason that the Shen keeps getting banned out, even if it's unfavorable matchups like the Gnar, is because they can run this strategy.
Yeah.
They could run the whole Evelynn for Moon, Twitch Piglet, and then Shen topside. Strategy they ended up running against Cloud9 Challenger, and it was really effective.
The old submarine. Oop. Moon is going to face check a Gragas. Gets the ward, though, and actually a level up, gets superior positioning. He's 10 CS ahead right now, and Team Liquid Academy use this vision now to collapse on the mountain grid.
Yep, Golden Glue goes straight for his upgrade, gets all the way up there. Now has that really fast ultimate, but he's still going to have to wait for another item, and this is going to help them take down more turrets and get more of that gold so they can hit those breakpoints. Because... by God, does Golden Glue need some help in this lane?
Oh, yeah.
Like, every game, you're just like, okay, maybe it's a bad matchup for him, or no. Nope. Every matchup. It just seems like it might be nerves. It might just be he just doesn't CS well. But we've seen him in the past actually have great advantages. He's more of a skirmishing player, right? When Quinn was a thing, he'd even play, like, Quinn mid, stuff like that. He just likes to team fight. So when he gets ahead or he's even, that's when we see TLA really go for those fights. When they're behind, that's when they flounder. It's just golden. It's pretty much off of Golden Glue too.
TLA now trying to convert in the top lane. Force the flash and the cask out of hard.
He flashed and then he just needed a drink after that.
Yeah. Needed to activate the passive for a little bit of health.
Yeah. I mean, I'd need a drink too if I wasted my flash.
But Team Liquid Academy now converting for the second turret of the game. Keith and Big are trading on the opposite side of the map, so it will be answered back, but this is Team Liquid Academy setting the pace now.
Yep. Turret gets answered. It's equal gold now. Afterwards. And now Piglet. Ah, yes. The solo lane farm for Piglet. Gets no assistance. But you can't really fight on this side of the map either, because you don't have Piglet. It's really risky.
Very greedy attempt, but Echo Fox know they've got the numbers advantage. Here comes Big.
This
and
is
the
still,
rest of Echo Fox.
This is flirting with death for TLA.
Laser gets dropped down onto Keith in the front. He eats some damage from the Chaos Storm. Heart is locked against the wall. First blood from Moon. KFO split from the rest of his team, and the Wish will provide enough sustenance to let Moon secure it.
And that's two kills going over to TLA. Piglet didn't even get a piece of that fight. 5 on 4, but the reason they went for it, Hard didn't have flash or ultimate. They knew that Soraka was safe in the backline, they knew that he wouldn't have a body slam flash to engage a fight, and they got to pick it at a decent range, and now they're gonna try to go for more.
Oh, Moon delays the knockup and forces flash out of Keith. Poison's not enough to kill him as Team Liquid Academy collapse on the mid-tier one. Ooh. It's still at full health and they don't have any minions.
Yeah, and Piglet flashed forward to try and get another auto attack off to finish off Keith. Didn't quite get it there. Flash shield used. Yep.
Trying to be sneaky, but
yeah. Golden Glue's really low, though.
That's flash used by Froggen to make sure that he's safe. The surprise factor from Team Liquid Academy. They are now 1,500 gold ahead, nearly, in this game. And all it takes is the tiniest little bit as Golden Glue gets denied his recall.
Yep. Another 8 seconds for him. Hard's going to clear out the pit, but it just seems as though they really want to get KFO this Rift Herald. Back timer's not that great. Golden Glue once again stops his. And Froggen, sure, he's on this Karma. Karma's not Vladimir. I'm going to tell you straight up right now.
Yeah.
He's not going to be doing the same type of damage. And whoa. KFO!
Solo got a kill.
I blinked.
Oh, the rest of the team. Keith actually is going to take the Rift Herald buff because KFO was dead. Miscommunication from Echo Fox really bites him.
The one time you want your top laner to really be up in there. Ooh, they can't leave it either. It expires after a decent amount of time. It's like down for 30 seconds or something. You can't be that indecisive.
But now that's Keith with the Rift Herald buff. Split, push, sipper, engage. He's going to try to keep up with Piglet, who has now shoved that bottom wave into his waiting arms. Stun is trying to get some wards on this side of the map, but his sight stone is all empty, so he gets some vision of the Krugs. As Keith starts to clear more and more of this out. So, Echo Fox, in the previous three games, in fact, we were praising them for their superior lanes, but while they were able to open up with superior lanes in this game, mm-hmm. Team Liquid Academy have just made a couple of aggressive plays that have gotten them those early turrets and gotten them those early kills.
Yeah, this just seems like laning versus actual strength. Piglet's gonna test his luck, though.
Oh, Keith gets slaughtered.
Yeah, there's a reason why this matchup is so good for Twitch. Just that range disadvantage. Keith had nothing either. He blew the flash and the heal. You open up and you're right on top of him. The Rift Herald kind of messed with Keith's head there because he's like, oh, it only works when I'm alone. I got to be alone, guys. Let me farm this lane.
Leave me alone. Let me get the solo experience.
Yeah, it's only half effective for range champions, too, mm-hmm. on the damage that it deals.
Team Liquid Academy are even going to shove this wave in so that on respawn, Keith won't have the luxury of being able to set up a freeze. Team Liquid Academy looking to bring us to game number 5. Even with all this pressure on the bottom lane, the mid lane is undefended.
And this is exactly what TLA needed for their bottom lane, because Golden Glue just keeps getting shut down. Hard is visiting top and mid, and he's just trying to sack bottom lane. It feels like Hard just doesn't want to go towards where Keith and Big are, and it's stopping Moon from doing so. But if you give a really favorable matchup to your bottom lane like this, you last pick your AD carry, you pick the Soraka away, you're going to have a really good time. And even though that looked like it was going to be rough early on, still, Piglet's able to get the better of a few fights, and this is going to be a great team fighting Twitch for him. Did I say team fighting? I meant scumbag Twitch.
Oh, there goes the wallop. KFO's in the front, and Piglet pops up just in time to get the kill. Now Froggen completes his teleport. So much regret. So much regret.
He didn't know. He didn't know.
He goes down. It's 6-0 for Team Liquid Academy. We said they played stompy. Well, game number 1 and game number 4 look to further reinforce that as they break down the mid-tier 1. Cloudrake has just spawned as well, and now even this mid-tier 2 is undefended.
Yep. Going to walk up with some attack speed here on Piglet, and this is going to be a tier 2 going down, and that is going to be a 5,000 gold lead for Team Liquid Academy. They want to force that game 5, and so far, it's been working out in their favor. Froggen on a much less abusable mid lane for himself. Piglet shows up, and it's hey.
Oh. I think he had like half a second to cancel.
Yeah.
Just barely.
Yeah. 2 kills going over to the Twitch, 3-0-0. Mm-hmm. And I think Cloudrake is actually fantastic on him too. Gives him a larger range in which he can choose to stealth and then rush in because of the movement speed.
Oh, nobody
Everybody saw that.
Just kidding, everybody saw that. Hard misses the body slam over the wall. And now Team Liquid Academy in control of this game. They have lost that one single turret in the bottom lane, but still controlling the map, trying to control the vision and look for more and more of these picks with Piglet's Twitch roaming all across the map.
He's doing mad work this game. Mm-hmm. And I'm glad they put him on a carry to force a game five, because I talked in the pregame about how he's wanting to carry. Soraka's going to suck playing up against that. And boom, lo and behold, they put Keith back on utility. He's going between Lucian and Sivir. A little bit of Ashe as well. But those are champions that still aren't going to hold up against this Twitch. And you're going to have to find a unique answer if this goes to game five, because Echofox,
ooh, backs against the wall. One game away, if that were to happen.
But what do you do ban-wise? Hecarim, Gangplank, Shen. You've stuck with these bans all four games. But that's a story for if it gets there.
Echofox are still in this game right here and now. Piglet in the front gets immediately body slammed and cast against the wall, saved by the Pillar of Filth. They're still trying to burn him down, but he gets a double kill as they stack up for the AoE. Flash dodges Froggen's damage. KFO is still chasing him down as Froggen in the front is running from those lines. He dodges around the back, and now KFO, the sole survivor, is separated from his team.
Oh, he was looking for Piglet. And Piglet got the stealth off. He got the reset.
Yeah.
So he goes back into stealth. And KFO can't finish off the vitals either. So Piglet survives. Baron looks like it's on the table here for TLA. And full confidence there. This is the champion that we're learning very quickly that you can't really give to Piglet in the right composition. This is the red side strat.
22-minute Baron picked up for Team Liquid Academy. 7,500 gold ahead.
This is just, he's got full confidence in his team, walks forward, opens up right in the face of the Gragas, the barrel as well. Pillar of Filth, you want it to catch Piglet. If that Pillar of Filth was just up a little bit further to the right, and then, he goes the other way too. So KFO is like looking around for him, and he was still getting the Fiora speed. And as soon as he lost it, he's just like, oh God, where is he?
I lost it.
I can't find him.
Oh,
whoa. Okay.
Piglet's on the prowl. 5-0-1, now with the Baron buff. Team Liquid Academy are looking to break open an inhibitor.
He's got a QSS as well. I mean, what's gonna really mess him up that can stun him? It's just the slow, or I guess the E from Gragas. He's gonna have to be really quick with that. And then the root from Karma, but if Karma's rooting you, she's in range to die. Speaking of range to die.
Yeah, Team Liquid Academy's pushed that range back as Echofox trying to hide behind the wall, play with the vision just a bit.
Yeah, this is where you get in that situation, you go, that last pick Twitch, man. That sucks, because we don't even have Rek'Sai to see him coming either. And he's at that point where that lane matchup was so good for him, and Keith pushed forward.
Gets scooped in. They're gonna try to kill Keith nice and quick. He drops to solo tether onto Golden Glue. He's in the front. Pillar Filth has been
in the
knocks
front.
Him in, but Piglet goes deep for Froggen, doesn't have the last auto, and health potions in the fountain keeps him alive. The inhibitor, however, has fallen. 5-4.
They're gonna try to end right now. It's 23 minutes in.
They have
really
one
the minions.
The first Nexus turret will drop, though. KFO splitting on the opposite side. Solo goes in. Hard dies to the combined might of Team Liquid Academy. They want this game five, and they are trying to claim it, but they need to break through Froggen and KFO first.
Yeah, and they decide not to take the risk here. Piglet's going to back off. Has a lot of gold in his pockets at the moment. It gets rid of the slow. Okay. So you QSS the slow. It goes off for a little bit since it's a slow zone, though. It sometimes reapplies right after, but still, they get away, they get their Baron recalls, and they're safe.
Yeah, they still have 90 seconds on that Baron buff, though, and it's only 24 and a half minutes in now that inhibitor is down. Cloud Drake will also spawn in 90 seconds, so even if they are unable to take another inhibitor, they have the opportunity to fall back and open up that advantage with some neutral objectives.
And you can see the difference this game as well. Like, with the fact that Froggen is on something that's a little bit less impactful, these neutral objectives, they aren't able to contest them as easily or as readily, because the Karma is just not the same type of impact. And sure, it's a Karma, right? But you can't really play to that lane. Vladimir, you can play to that lane. You can gank that lane over and over again and be like, all right, we're winning the game. You gank for Karma, it's like, she's going to have a Athene's.
Yeah.
She's going to get her Ardent Sensor to give attack speed to one of our carries.
that's falling behind because of lane matchups.
Still a CS advantage for Keith and CS advantage for KFO as he was split pushing on the other side of the map. He's got teleport once again, but Team Liquid Academy just rush in, not up on the lead. Piglet is going to slip away, and he goes deep. He gets Keith. And the rest of Team Liquid Academy, they haven't even finished off the turret yet.
That was actually a really smooth, kind of engage from Solo. The jump in, the gnar backwards, it looked like it was mid-leap as well. So Solo, real quick on that combination. That's going to be another turret going down. KFO still on split push duty.
Yeah, Baron has just fallen off, but they've already broken the turret and will now break the inhibitor. KFO completing his recall, but that inhibitor has gone down. Keith is still dead. Are they going to try to push for the second Nexus turret without the Baron buff? Piglet's in the back. Flash body slam. Cat's going to Golden Glue. He flashes back, but is kept alive. Piglet's in the thick of things, dishing out as much damage as possible, and Golden Glue will escape on the side. Keith will sidestep and keep his life as Keith respawns. The Nexus turret stands, and Team Liquid Academy back away. 11,000 gold stronger than Echo Fox.
26 and a half minutes in. And TLA, they want to force that game five. They want to put it even footing again. They did it against Cloud9 Challenger. No Ram is picked today. See how this one ends up.
That is Cloud Drake taken. Three Drakes now for Team Liquid Academy. In complete control of this game. Hard. Hoping to gift that blue buff over to Froggen, but Froggen is clearing minions in the mid lane, so now he's got to stand here for a little bit.
Ooh. So, Piglet, his build, he went for the QSS because there's like maybe one or two things he really wants to QSS. It's a little strange, but it does help him in the magic resist department. It's a magic resist item you want as an AD carry unless you're going Maw. And then he went for a Vamp Scepter, but now he's going Pickaxe, I assume because he wants the Infinity Edge. In third item Twitch, Infinity Edge is usually what you see. But now his inventory is completely full. He's not going to be able to add any more components. So we're not going to see any spikes from Piglet unless he's sitting on about 2,000 plus gold, which means that TLA, they want to end the game pretty much now before it gets to that point where you have to just stall for maybe 7 minutes, 8 minutes before Piglet even gets enough gold.
Well, so far he's a full level ahead of Keith at level 14. As Team Liquid Academy start pressuring the one remaining inhibitor turret. Solo again goes in, and Keith, they're trying to keep him alive. He flashes. Piglet, KFO gets in. He's trying to kill Solo. He's taking so much of the turret. Solo shielded is staying alive, but Piglet and Golden Glue are cleaning it up. A double kill for Piglet.
Ah.
Golden Glue scares away, and that's KFO having to retreat. Triple kill now. And Piglet lands the slow, but is just going to be content to end the game. Drop the Nexus. Who needs a quadra kill when we've got a game five on our hands? Never mind, that is a quadra kill as he gets it, and it goes down. Team Liquid Academy, take us to game number five with an amazingly dominant win.
Looks like the QSS is for Exhaust because he wants to walk straight into the back line. Exhaust range there, and we're going to get game five here.
Woo! Backs against the wall, the elimination game.
This is why I love these types of series where it's back and forth instead of just like 3-0 or like the game one just becomes the story of every single game where they just stomp them over and over again. I like the back and forth because it's the adjustments that we're seeing. TLA pulled an audible champion select, get Piglet to carry, and it's not because they're saying like, oh, we're frustrated, we need Piglet to carry. It's that's not the lane that Echo Fox is playing to, ever. They play to KFO, they're playing to Froggen, they're not playing towards Keith and Big. In fact, they're putting him on things like Soraka and Trundle, where they're just buying time in lane and trying to win through sustain.
Well, it has been working for them, and this series is going the distance. We're going to kick it back over to the analyst desk to go over the action so far.
Thanks, guys. And you know,
let's go. Game five.
There you go. Game five. Let's go. It is going to be a very big one for these two teams, you know, to say the least. It's so much on the line. And when it comes down to it, this was kind of Echo Fox not really being able to compete in a game where TLA kind of mixed it up a bit, right? You know, they take Froggen off of this champion where he can dominate. He's in a supportive role, but if the rest of your team is not kind of putting out those care performances, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, and I did like the way they mix it up. They have the former world champion on a challenger team. Yep. Let's let him have last pick. Let's put him on a hyper carry. And I do feel like that final two picks at the very end of the draft, where they decided to go with essentially the Karma mid lane and then kind of swap Trundle down to support. Yep. You kind of had to know that if they're saving their last pick for an AD, it's going to be some type of hyper carry thing.
Yeah.
So I really didn't like the fact that they decided to go Karma mid there.
Yeah.
Right? They should have just, I think, had Karma support. And even though there weren't many carries there, Zirene was talking about Cassiopeia over and over again. I think that would have been great.
Yeah, I think Cassiopeia would have been great too. And, you know, whether or not you think Froggen is the best Thalia player in the world, he did have some pretty decent games on it in the LCS, so he has been able to play that. But yeah, I also thought it was pretty telegraphed when you are leaving it, that it is going to be, you know, I was kind of joking about Vayne, right? But yeah. it was obvious that it was going to be something situational, right? You don't leave your AD carry to last and then just pick Ashe, right? It's not something that you generally do. And giving up their lane dominance in the bot lane is something that they had, right? This is one of their advantages is in all these games. They have been winning lanes, even ones that they lost.
And even with all that being said, the early game was still kind of going the way it has gone the whole series. Echo Fox is winning the majority of the lanes, but it wasn't until they tried to do the Rift Herald in the face of everyone on Team Liquid Academy at 15 minutes as we have a replay up right now.
This was, I just don't even have words for this. I mean, this
the
was
whole TLA is there aside from Twitch.
Yeah, and you have to also remember that this was right after Gragas just ultimated nothing, and Fiora had to use her ultimate in the 1v1, right? So they're taking so much damage from this. Both the people that are actually taking the damage from the Rift Herald do not have their ultimates. So neither of them have ultimates. They're doing it in vision instead of backing out. You know, KFO's flashing in to go one way and try to fight. And it's like, what is happening? I mean, at that point, the game was going fine, right? Yeah. And the plan was clearly, okay, yeah, sure, maybe Twitch is going to outcarry the Sivir, but Fiora's going to split push, and we're going to have this four-man squad with tons of speed-ups, tons of disengage, right? And I like the idea behind it. You have Karma for speed-ups, Sivir for speed-ups, you have Trundle slow, Gragas disengage. You should not be able to hard engage on that former end squad if they're playing safely. Yeah. And then on the other side, it's supposed to be KFO, you know, getting that Rift Herald buff, not in this way, but getting it. And
somehow.
And then exactly. And then just pushing until he takes inhibitors, right? Just getting that massive advantage and go late. But this was just way too greedy.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a lot of pressure on both these teams, obviously. Yeah. A loss means you're put into the challenger scene and you have no chance of getting back into the LCS.
Yep.
And even Team Liquid Academy does seem now, within two best of five series, a really inconsistent team from game to game. The first four games of their series against Cloud9 Challenger were basically the same, where they're just trading wins with massive stomps and huge losses.
Yeah, and then the tough part for these teams is, doesn't matter how close the series is, it all comes down to the result. But moving forward from that, the lead was really able to be extended by Piglet in these side lanes, kind of abusing Twitch on these assassinations. And here is victim number one, Keith with his Rift Herald buff, as he was able to pick up later, getting blasted by Piglet.
That damage reduction, though.
Yeah, that was hype. Almost had a Keith, but
that was a disaster.
Up in the top lane, you know, this is another fight, and this one goes really bad because Froggen's thinking, oh, great, we're going to have the 2v1 here against KFO, against Solo with KFO, thinking they're going to turn it around. But right as Piglet opens up, the TP completes, and then it's another 2v1, giving over not only the summoner spell, but a second free kill.
Yeah, and it's kind of like the series of events of, even though we feel like Echo Fox left the door wide open for Team Liquid Academy to get the lead, we still have to credit Piglet for just using his stealth really well and finding exactly the opportunities to kind of start blowing the game wide open.
Yeah, and I mean, it's a lot about knowing your limits. When you are really far ahead, you can play aggressively, and he did that very well throughout the rest of the game, you know, opening up in melee range for these guys sometimes because he knew he was so strong and he had the support of his team. So, you know, really well-played game there from Piglet. And then, you know, it all came down to one final fight around Baron. It was 4-for-1 and Baron. And this is where the game was really sealed.
Yeah, and this was another one of these fights where, like, Echo Fox is trying to make a play, but mainly it's because Piglet opens up. Really unlucky, I feel like, with the way that pillar had gone up. It almost looked like it blocked the Gragas ultimate from being able to knock him back. And it also stopped Echo Fox from being able to close in on Piglet. Then it goes from bad to worse because Piglet's able to stealth away. Echo Fox runs to the other side. Whoops-a-daisy, and because they were able to kill so many people while still keeping their damage dealers alive, 21-minute Baron, after already getting a bunch of picks and getting a bunch of kills, icing on the cake.
Yep, exactly, and the gold lead was enormous at that point, right? So early in the game, that was only 21 minutes in, and they're like 10,000 gold ahead, but you can say a little bit unlucky with that ultimate, but at the same time, it's like the Trundle pillar essentially saved him, right? You shouldn't have thrown it there. You have to make sure that it's behind pushing into your team. In this case, Piglet was essentially able to use it to zone out. And he actually got down to about 10% HP during that fight. Had that pillar been properly placed and he died right off the bat, this could be a very different fight, perhaps a very different game.
Yeah, well, essentially, I feel like when Twitch opens up stealth on you that close, like, you probably shouldn't even be pillaring him.
Yeah.
Because he's clearly picked that spot to go. So either dump a bunch of damage or you just grog assault him back straight away. But to put a pillar straight in front of him, you're actually just like, Twitch, can't shoot through the pillar. You can't shoot through the pillar.
Yeah, he's got the wall hacks on. But it is going to be Echo Fox going for blue side here in game five.
Yeah.
And that has been the norm. Yeah.
So that means they're going to have to switch it up, right?
Yeah.
Because Echo Fox got three mid lane bans thrown against them by Team Liquid Academy, and then Victor taken away.
Yeah.
So they ended up going with Karma, and that put Froggen in a pretty uncomfortable situation.
And we also have to remember, though, you know, game one looked really bad, right? And then Echo Fox drafts the exact same thing, and then makes it look pretty darn good. So, you know, this may be one of those things where they're saying, hey, sure, this didn't look great. And I think a lot of people are going to be talking about, well, Froggen's been dominating. Froggen's your best player. Why isn't Froggen on a hard carry, right? Why isn't Froggen on the Cassiopeia? And I think that's, while that's fair to say, at the same time, there was obviously some very tragic mistakes that happened. Just look at the Rift Herald fight that made it so that it's like, while your composition could work, it cannot work from that sort of a deficit, right? So I think that they may possibly have the confidence just go right back at it and say, hey, we won't make those mistakes again. They did it in game two. It's not necessarily guaranteed that they're going to do it here in game five with everything on the line. But I definitely think that was a composition that could have won. While maybe not perfect, we'll see what Echo Fox thinks.
Right. We talk about the first 10 minutes of the game.
Yeah.
It was pretty smooth for them. KFO has had some good performances on Fiora, even if they consistently teamfight with it. I will say their best win of the series did come when they picked a team fighting composition.
Yeah.
That was game three. And there's always a chance, you know, Team Liquid Academy locks in Rammus. So,
and that. You can always hope for that. I definitely think TLA fans are not hoping for the Rammus in game five. We'll find out if we see it. But call your friends. The match deciding game five between Echo Fox and Team Liquid Academy is coming up right after the break. We'll be right back.
All
right.
Team Liquid Academy were able to win game number one by finding superior fight after superior fight. We'll see if they can get the better of this game, because a loss here means elimination from the promotion tournament. There goes the wallop. KFO's in the front, and Piglet pops up just in time to get the kill. Now Froggen completes his teleport. So much regret. So much regret.
I'm pushing off Karma.
I got Sivir.
I'm on Karma right now. I'm finishing Karma and then I'll peel.
And Keith, they're trying to keep him alive. He flashes. Piglet. KFO gets in. He's trying to kill Solo. He's taking so much of the turret. Solo shielded is staying alive, but Piglet and Golden Glue are cleaning it up. A double kill. Team Liquid Academy, take us to game number five with an amazingly dominant win.